The Energy Department urges Filipinos to shift to electric vehicles. Aside from environmental benefits, DOE says drivers can also save more, as going electric will spare them from fluctuating pump prices. Alvin El Chico has more.
Leon Conson earns around 1,000 pesos driving an e-trike in Mandaluyong City. He pays a boundary fee of 200 pesos to the city government, which includes the electrical charging of the vehicle. Leon used to drive a gasoline-fed motorcycle before he shifted to e-trike.
Tahimik ang e-trike, hindi malog, walang usok, environmental, di ba? Sa e-trike talaga, hindi naman lahat ng araw ma-label mo yung kita. Pinaka-lowest talaga 600-800. Pinaka-mataas 1514, ganun. Pag masipag kaabot pang 2,000.
Under Mandaluyong City's program, these donated e-trikes will eventually be turned over to drivers like Leon.
Matagumpay po sa aking pong pagtaya na napakaganda po kasi na proyektong ginawa ng ating dating Mayor Amenchi Abalos. Talaga pong napakinabangan po, hindi lamang po ng constituent ng Mandaluyong, pati po ang ating mga school, 23 school po, nabigyan po natin.
Part po ng napagkasunduan sa donation, yung maipon na funds ay for acquiring new units para madagdagan at ma-replenish po ito. Part nga po ng commitment ng Mandaluyong ay mapa-improve po yung transport sector. Lalo na po sa Mandaluyong, ideal yung ganitong unit dahil unang natahimik at saka yung contribution niya sa kabawasan ng pollution.
The Energy Department has been pushing for more e-vehicles to the country to lessen dependence on fossil fuels. DOE Director Patrick Aquino says drivers can save more with e-vehicles.
Kung ang presyo ng ating gasolina ay 62 pesos per liter, mm-hmm, at yung ating kuryente ay under 10 pesos, mga 9 plus pesos per kilowatt hour, yung kung pareho yung tinatakbo ng pure electric at saka ng gasolina, mga nasa mga 40-50% less yung gastos.
Aside from e-trikes and cars, the DOE wants to include electric motorcycles in the executive order on tax exemption for imported e-vehicles. Aquino says there will be a price reduction of 10,000 to 30,000 pesos per unit of e-motorcycle once the import tax is removed. The same EO will also slash 100,000 to 500,000 pesos on the price of imported electric four-wheeled vehicles. To encourage more e-vehicles in the country, more perks are being planned.
Ikaw ay mas mura yung pagrehistro mo. Wala kang volume vehicle reduction scheme. So wala kang number or color coding. So yun yung ating pang ibang pagganyo sa ating mga kababayan na lumipat sa electric vehicles. At saka mabanggit ko lang, meron rin tayong mga pribadong establishmento or mall na nagbibigay ng libreng charging.
Most motorists in the Philippines are prone to price fluctuations of imported fossil fuels. For example, the first trading day this week showed a more than 1 peso per liter hike in the prices of imported diesel and gasoline. But there are 4 more trading days that may temper or, worse, bloat the current increase in fuel prices, which will be reflected in the pumps in the Philippines next week. Alvin El Chico, ABS-CBN News.
The National Grid Corporation of the Philippines has begun the second phase of its 10.6 billion peso Mindanao substation upgrading program. The NGP says it has already energized a 100 megavolt ampere power transformer in the Toril substation, which powers Davao City. Under the project, 10 substations from Llano del Norte, Tumisamis Oriental, Bukidnon, and Cotabato will be equipped with new power transformers that will ensure continuous operations in case of outages. NGCP says this will enhance the Mindanao grid's ability to withstand major system disturbances. The government's plan to privatize the Nino Aquino International Airport moving along, with the Transportation Department starting to solicit private sector proposals for a 15-year contract to upgrade and run the country's main gateway. This early, the DOTR says the NAIA terminal fee may increase by nearly 50% to 800 pesos once privatized. But this will mean better passenger experience. This push, supported by several lawmakers, including Senators Grace Poe and Cheese Escudero.
Because there's a lot of upside when you operate NAIA, mm-hmm, and introduce efficiencies. Mm-hmm. And when you say introduce efficiencies, that means you can process more passengers. Mm-hmm. You can take in more flights. Mm-hmm. That will just increase the the top end of the balance sheet. No? More revenues means a larger share for the government.
An infrastructure-oriented think tank welcomes the government's action. It says NAIA's rehabilitation has been long overdue.
Dapat matagal nang nangyari yan. Kasi talagang panahon pa huli Pangulong Duterte, meron akong plano na rehabilitate yung NAIA. Dapat kahapon pa huli yan na ilapag. Dapat hindi na ho pinaproblema ng kasalukuyang gobyerno kung hindi ho minotball or shineld ng nagdaang gobyerno yung pong rehabilitation ng NAIA.
Finishing touches are being made to the controversial Maharlika Investment Fund Act before it is sent to Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. for his signature. Senate Majority Leader Joel Villanueva says these include a correction to provisions which have conflicting prescription periods for violations of the act. He also insists government institutions managing state pensions cannot directly invest in the Maharlika Fund but will be allowed to invest in projects financed by it. Senate Minority Leader Coco Pimentel earlier urged the president to veto the bill. Pimentel believes it's full of ambiguities and loopholes.
The ball is still with the Senate office, secretariat, at pina-finalize po, still in the process of cleaning up the bill, finalizing yung mga typographical errors and other clerical errors, and to avoid inconsistency.
The Philippine Agriculture Department inks a deal with the South Korean Agricultural Machinery Cooperative, CAMICO, to further mechanize the agri-sector here at home. Under the agreement, a local agricultural machinery manufacturing cluster will be established to include an assembly production line, while workforce training on machinery will be conducted. President Marcos, who is also the concurrent agriculture chief, expressed his confidence in the partnership, saying this will result in better yield and lower production costs to make Filipino farmers more competitive. The World Bank says the global economy is in a precarious situation and heading for a substantial slowdown as sharp interest rate increases hit activity and make lower-income countries even more vulnerable. The multilateral lender had actually raised its 2023 global growth forecast to 2.1% from the 1.7% predicted in January, citing a strong start to the year. But this is still slower than last year's actual growth of 3.1%. It also cut its 2024 prediction to 2.4% from the initial forecast of 2.7%. It cited pandemic shocks, Russia's invasion of Ukraine, and the sharp slowdown amid tight global financial conditions. It also notes how the outlook for emerging market and developing economies is particularly worrisome amid aggressive monetary tightening, boosting the likelihood that economies could face a financial crisis. As for the Philippines, economic growth is seen slowing down to 6% this year from last year's actual growth of 7.6%.